Good evening, sir. Here Abhimanyu, roll number belongs to 3. I'm going to talk about the effect of wind and ice loading on transmission lines. So what we are going to discuss is that if in the areas of high snowfall and high windy situations, the effects of that winds and ice accumulations in the transmission lines leads to some disturbances in effective distribution of the electricity. So about that, here I am going to explain in detail. That is, the weight of the ice acts vertically downwards. That is, if ice is accumulated over the transmission line, the weight of that ice will act downwards to that downwards, and the weight will be forced on that transmission line. That is, as the same direction as the weight of the conductor. And the in windy conditions, the force due to wind is assumed to act horizontally. That is, wind blow horizontally, so the force of the wind is assumed to act horizontally. That is, right angle to the projected surface of the conductor. Hence, the total force in some sort of situation, high wind and high snowfall, the total force on the conductor is the vector sum of horizontal and vertical forces. It can be calculated as the total weight of the conductor per unit length is, that is, Wt is equal to square root of W plus Wi the whole square plus Ww the whole square, where W is the weight of the conductor per unit length. That is nothing but a conductor material density into volume per unit length. Here with the diagram, we can see the ice coating. That center thing is the conductor with the diameter D, and the over coating is that ice coating with a thickness of T. And Vi is the weight of the ice per unit length. That is nothing but a density into volume of the ice per unit length. That is respective formula, we can calculate as density of ice into pi t of d plus t. Next, WW, that is wind force per unit length. That is wind pressure per unit area into projected area per unit length. That is equal to wind pressure into d bracket of a d plus 2t into 1. That is the for per unit length we are focusing on the projecting area. That is if one side wind blowed means we are calculating that side with respect to. So when the conductor has wind and ice also, the following points may be also noted. That is, the conductor sets itself in a plane at an angle theta to the vertical, where that is there are two forces acting, so WW and W plus WI, that is wind force per unit length and wind force and plus ice coating that force. We are getting these two vectors. So two vectors leads to a resultant vector, that is a Vt, that is total force per unit length of that conductor. And itself make an angle of theta, where it can be calculated as tan theta is equal to WW divided by W plus WI. That is a mathematical expression. So with this concluded formula, we can also calculate the sag in the conductor. That is given by S is equal to Wt L square divided by 2T, and hence S, in that S represents the slant slag in a direction making an angle theta to the vertical, and the vertical sag can be given as S cos theta. So thank you, sir. Have a nice day.